Pulse here on Mirror Now. I'm Amita Balachandra. Today we're going to be talking about a horrific incident that's come to light from the city of Bengaluru. A 23-year-old girl was held hostage inside a cab, molested by the cab driver, and then later threatened, all because of what is called as a child lock system. That the car that we're talking about was child locked. We're going to take you through that system and demonstrate how it exactly works later on the show. But also coming up on the show, killer negligence from Max Hospital. The second newborn who was found to be alive now passes away at a hospital in Pritampura. In the meantime, Max Hospital found guilty of violating norms. Also coming up, a 3-year-old boy loses his life after the ambulance he was being shifted in runs out of oxygen. Instead of helping, the driver abandons the vehicle. Top focus this evening is a horrific incident that's come to light from the city of Bengaluru, where a 23-year-old woman was held hostage inside a cab, all because of a child lock system that was active inside that cab. At Mirror Now, we've been campaigning against this child lock system in these cabs. We'll come to that later on the show. But first, let me go across to Shrija, who's joining us from Bengaluru, who will take us through this incident that took place. Shrija, if you can take us through what exactly happened. What are the allegations being leveled now by the victim?
If you really go by the victim's account, she did, of course, book an Ola cab, is what we're given to understand. This is on Sunday night at 10:30 p.m. With the taxi aggregator Ola. And this particular driver, Mr. Rajshekhar Reddy, picked her up from especially Indira Nagar. She was, in fact, heading towards BTM layout, is what we're given to understand. Now, if you really go by what the victim has accused this particular person, is Rajshekhar Reddy, is that he, on the way, while traveling on the way, he stopped at an isolated place especially near Intermediate Ring Road, and in fact also locked the child lock, is what we're given to understand, and started sexually harassing her. Now, this is going by the victim's account. Of course, she did not have any help. Remember, it was at 10:30 in the night, no help, and an isolated place. And she, of course, continuously started also shouting at the driver to leave her alone. She started banging on the windows of this particular car, is what we're given to understand. And later, after that harrowing experience, only then this particular driver let her go off, is what we are given to understand. But the shocking part over here is the victim has not registered any complaint with the police station, because remember, she did, of course, visit the Madiwala police station. She did speak to the inspector. But all that we hear is the inspector gave a proper hearing to the driver and let go of him. But if you really go by the law, you clearly know that the police has the rule, also has the right to go or take her suo motu cognizance if any crime is reported or it comes to their notice. Well, that was also not clearly done. But the victim hoped that the Ola taxi aggregator would take a stringent action against this particular driver. But however, not much action, stringent action was initiated, because a formal complaint was not filed with the police. And all that they have done at this point in time is suspend this particular driver.
All right, Shrija, you've been, of course, saying that the formal complaint has not yet been filed. Is the victim now going to continue to put pressure on the police and, get a formal complaint filed? Also, I believe you have the accused with you. Remember, the police, like Shrija was pointing out, let the accused go. What is his version of the event?
Well, of course, I'll just first question. Iga Rajshekhar avattu yavaga nadithittu ee ghatane enaitu avaga
madam idu banwara night 10 varege booking bantu 10 varege CMH road inda direct silk board u turn hatra third cross alli nandella ond 25 nimisha drop maadibitte ನಂದಂಗೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಡಿವಾಲ ಫ್ಲೈಓವರ್ ಮೇಲೆಯಿಂದ ಬುಕಿಂಗ್ ಬಂತು. ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇಂದ್ರಾನಗರ ಹತ್ರ ರಮೇಶ್ ನಗರ ಎಲ್ ಬಿ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಿ ನಗರ ಡ್ರಾಪು. ಒಂದು ಅರ್ಧ ತಾರೀಕು ಬಂದೆ, ಅವರು ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ ಅಂತಾರು. ಅವರು ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಈ ಥರ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು. ಇಲ್ಲ ಮೇಡಮ್, ಆ ಥರ ಏನೂ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನೀವು ನಂದ ಇಲ್ಲ ಬೇರೆ ನಂಬರ್ ಯಾವುದನ್ನು ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಅಂದರು. ಮತ್ತು ಇದು ಮತ್ತೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ದೊಮ್ಮೂರು ಹತ್ರ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಬೇರೆ ಓಲಾ ಆಟೋ ಬುಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋದ್ರಂತೆ. ಅದೇನು ಮ್ಯಾಟ್ರ್ ಕೂಡ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ನಡೆದೇ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಅವ್ರ ಮನೆ ಮುಂದೆ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಅವ್ರ ಮನೆ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಅವ್ರ ಮನೆ ಮುಂದ್ಗಡೆ ಒಂದು ರೋಡಲ್ಲಿ ರೋಡ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಆಗೋಕ್ಕೆ ಗಾಡಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ, ಮೂರು ಪಿಲ್ಲರ್ ಕೂಡ ಹಾಕವ್ರೆ. ಅವ್ರ ಮನೆ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಎಲ್ಲ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ಇದೇನು ಮ್ಯಾಟ್ರ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ.
ನೀವು ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇಂಟರ್ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟ್ ರಿಂಗ್ ರೋಡ್ ಹತ್ರ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ?
ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಂದು ಪೂರಾ ಎವಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಇದೆ ಓಲಾದಲ್ಲಿ. ನಾನು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸಿರ್ತೀನಿ, ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತೀನಿ, ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಇರ್ತದೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸಿರೋದು ಕೂಡ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಡಾಕ್ಯುಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದೆ.
ಈಗ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ವಿಕ್ಟಿಮ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಈಗ ನೀವು ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಲಾಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ, ಅದರಿಂದ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಹೊರಗೆ ಹೋಗಕ್ಕೆ ಚಾನ್ಸೇ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ?
ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಥರ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಸುಳ್ಳು ಪ್ರಚಾರ, ಆ ಥರ ಏನು ಕೂಡ ಇಲ್ಲ. ನಾನು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ 25 ನಿಮಿಷ ಇಲ್ಲ 30 ನಿಮಿಷದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಮನೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಅವ್ರ ಮನೆ ನೋಡಿಸ್ತೀನಿ. ಮತ್ತು ಇದೇ ಥರ ನನಗೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಡೌಟ್ ಬಂದು, ಮತ್ತೆ 12 ಗಂಟೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಖಾಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಮರಿವಾಲ್ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ಗೆ ನೈಟ್ 12 ಗಂಟೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಅವ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಮಾತಾಡಿ ನಂದು ಆಧಾರ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟು, ಸರ್ ಈ ಥರ ಈ ಅನ್ನೋ ನಂಬರಿಂದ ನನಗೆ ಕಾಲ್ ಬರ್ತೈತೆ, ಈ ಥರ ಏನೇನೋ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತವ್ರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ನನ್ನ ಆಧಾರ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನನ್ನ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ಸ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಆ ಮೇಡಮ್ದು ಅನ್ನೋ ನಂಬರ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟು, ಅವ್ರು ಇದ್ಕೊಂಡು ಏನೂ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ನಾಳೆ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಅವ್ರು ಬಂದರೆ ನಾನು ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಕಳಿಸ್ತಿರು.
ಅವರು ಮನೆಯನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನೀವು ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದಿರಾ?
ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು
ತುಂಬ ಸತಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದಿರಾ.
ಫುಲ್ ಎವಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ನನ್ನ ಕಾಲ್ ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ. ನಾನು ಒಂದು ಸತಿ ಕೂಡ ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ಗೆ ಮಾಡೇ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಕಸ್ಟಮರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡೇ ನನಗೂ ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಈ ಥರ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇರೋದು. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಕೂಡ ನಾನು ಒಂದು ಸತಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಕಾಲ್.
Well, you are having the person who's been accused of, in fact, harassing this particular victim. He's made it very clear saying that he did not stop as far as what the victim is claiming. He's also proving that he has evidence because the Ola records in the system, this which clearly says they do not stop at one particular location. Have they stopped, then that particular evidence will be recorded. But clearly he's saying that he has that evidence where he has dropped this particular victim to her desired location. Instead, another customer, her friend, one of her friends got along with her, and that is when the altercation led to this particular accusation, is what clearly Rajshekhar at this point in time pointing out. Alright, Shija, you know, one quick question. Like you pointed out, the accused driver, they're denying all allegations made by the victim. What is the victim's response to this when you spoke to her? Well, we did, of course, get in touch with the victim. We clearly asked her as far as the child lock system is concerned. But if you really go by the victim's version, she clearly makes it a point by saying that she was stopped. That is, the cab stopped at this particular location. That is the intermediate ring road near between 10:30 and 10:45. And the child lock system was activated. After which, the driver, in fact, Rajshekhar Reddy, went about harassing her, sexually exploiting her. Clearly, this is the claims which she has made. But really, we have the accused with us, where he's trying to rubbishing all such claims made by this particular victim, saying that he has, of course, provided the evidence to the Ola taxi aggregator, also to the police, Madiwala police, where they called him, and after in fact checking all the facts, that is when he was let go of.
All right, Shija, many thanks for getting us all those details. Shija, they're getting us the latest update on that horrific incident that took place in Bengaluru, where a 23-year-old woman was allegedly held hostage inside the cab. The accused driver a while ago spoke to us saying that all of these allegations are false and that he has evidence to prove that it is false. Now, while this is a one-off case that we're talking about that happened in Bengaluru, there have been several other cases that have come to light simply because the child lock was on, and a lot of people were either molested, assaulted inside the cab while the child lock was on. In fact, we have Rehan now joining us from Autocar, who will take us through this entire process. Rehan, what are we learning today? How important is it to ensure that there is a child lock system?
Well, child lock is a very, very important feature that's been on cars for many, many years now, and it's an extremely useful feature, especially when you're driving with your family and things like that. But it does pay to know exactly how it works, because for the system to work, you really need to be kind of aware of what to do and in what order to do it.
Now, before we, of course, get into the nitty-gritties, I would like you to come out and show us how this entire system works. In fact, we have Rehan now showing us how the child lock system works. In fact, we're going to look at an
older car.
You would have a switch very similar to this right here to turn it on and off. And the idea being, when you turn the child lock on, the car is now no longer, the door of the car is now no longer openable from the inside. So if I got in, I wouldn't be able to accidentally open the door and fall out. The downside to this, of course, being that you have to have someone from the outside come and open it up for you.
So every car has this?
Every car for many, many years has had this. And in fact, it was a problem previously to this that children were switching it off and were had the problem of falling out of the car without anyone knowing because the parent assumed that the child lock was on. These days, on a more advanced car, we would have a key that had to be inserted to turn it on and off.
So I'm going to ask you to lock it right now. It's locked. I'm going to sit inside the car. As you see, the windows are rolled up, and I'm going to now lock myself in. It is obviously locked. I can't open it, and there is no way to open this. I would like you to now open the car. The door can only be opened from outside if it's child locked.
Yes, that's right. It can only be opened from the outside to prevent anyone from accidentally opening it.
So then, how important is it for anybody who gets into a car, any commercial vehicle, because a lot of us take Ola, Uber, other cars as well. How important is it to quickly check whether the child lock is on or not?
Honestly, it would be extremely important if it wasn't your own personal car. This was designed for, it was a system that was designed for people who were driving their own personal cars and wanted to have complete control over what's going on. So if you are getting into a commercial vehicle you do obviously need to exit in case of an emergency, as you get on, checking that the child lock is off is of utmost importance.
In fact, you were also pointing out how the newer cars now have an upgraded system of the child lock. In fact, let's show our viewers what you're talking about. If you can show us how upgraded the system is, really.
A newer Hyundai Verna, and in the newer systems, it's much, much simpler, as you can see. There's no switch or lock button. It's just a very simple little notification thing and a little hole. And in effect, if I insert the car key into here and twist it, the child lock is now engaged. And the advantage to this system was to prevent anyone from accidentally switching it off.
In fact, I'm going to ask you to lock it and literally sit inside and test this out as well in the upgraded version. The door is open, I'm trying to open, and I can't open it. So, one important question that I want to ask you. There are obviously a lot of pros and cons to child lock system. And at Mirror now, we've been pushing for stickers to be put up in all commercial vehicles, telling people that there is this child lock system. But you believe that it must be there in any car. Why is that?
Well, it is an essential system that, when used correctly, has great benefits to commercial and private vehicles. As the driver, should have complete control over what is going on in your car, and it's better to know that the people sitting in the back, if they are children, are completely safe and aren't capable of, opening the door and jumping out at high speeds, which can be a very, very big problem and has been.
Obviously, now in both the cars, you've shown us how the child lock system can be opened from outside. If it's locked, I can't open, I can't roll down the windows, I can't do anything. You have to open it from outside. But can the driver open the child lock system as well?
No, that is not possible. The child lock system has to be manually unlocked on each car by opening the door and accessing this panel right here. So it is a manual system built into the door lock itself.
Now, you were also pointing out how important it is to have the child lock system in cars, but in most commercial vehicles, how many times does it happen that a child, tends to fall out? I mean, we've seen in the recent past that a lot of cases have come up where women have alleged that they've been, held hostage inside the cab because of the child lock system.
Well, I think in the past there have been cases of children falling out, which is where the system was really invented and kind of developed. In recent times, though, I'm not quite sure of the exact figures, but it's kind of prevented more than we can say it hasn't. So it is a useful system in itself, but it does, of course, have its downsides.
Now, one quick question before we end this conversation, of course, if you can tell us, do you believe that it should be eliminated from commercial vehicles at all, or maybe a sticker would be the best thing to do? What other precautionary measures should the state governments, for instance, take?
I do not believe that it should be removed from cars. I think it is, in commercial vehicles as well, is a very, very useful system. However, the important part about all of this is for the public to be aware of how the system works and how you can prevent getting into a problem with the child lock. For instance, putting the window down and opening the door from the outside is always a possibility, provided the window lock hasn't also been engaged. So there's all sorts of intricacies to the system, but if you have an understanding of vaguely how it works, you shouldn't really have a problem.
All right, Rehan, many thanks for joining us here on Mirror Now there. Rehan, really pointing out the importance of a child lock system there, however, also saying that the state governments perhaps must put up stickers in all of these commercial vehicles, something that we have been pushing here on Mirror Now as well. With that, let's now take a look at what else is making news across the nation. First of all, onto our continued focus coming in from a Delhi Max Hospital, where a newborn was declared dead to the parents' utter shock. Of course, now that we understand that newborn has in fact passed away, Apurva Sridhar gets us all the details.
The baby was probably septic and he was bleeding from, he was having DIC. His platelets were low, his hemoglobin was low, and his urine output was coming low. So probably if he had given a little more time, right now after a few hours, probably at sometime he would have needed peritoneal dialysis.
What time did the baby breathe his last?
12:08 we have declared. But we were trying to revive the baby for the previous 1 hour or so.
तो गलती कहाँ हुई कि आपने टेम्परेचर को मिस किया. ये एरर ऑफ डायग्नोसिस है. इससे पहले जून में सफदरजंग में भी ऐसा केस हुआ. हर साल ऐसे केसेस होते हैं. क्योंकि गलती हुई, गलती के लिए आपको मेडिकल काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया या स्टेट मेडिकल काउंसिल जो भी पनिशमेंट देना चाहे आप दोगे, लेकिन जेल नहीं बनती. गाइडलाइन से एक नॉर्म आना चाहिए कि किसी भी बच्चे को, न्यू बॉर्न को बिना रेक्टल टेम्परेचर लिए डिक्लेयर डेड ना करो. अब ये नॉर्म पूरे हॉस्पिटल का कल्चर बनना चाहिए.
Now, medical apathy that has claimed yet another life. A three-year-old boy, we understand, was being shifted in a private ambulance to Hyderabad, died after the ambulance ran out of oxygen. We understand, shockingly, instead of trying to help, the driver abandoned the help and immediately fled. Paul gets us more details.
This is a case of sheer negligence coming to light from Adilabad. Firstly, it was a private ambulance, but the hospital authority should have ensured that the ambulance driver really checked whether there was enough oxygen supply in the ambulance before they actually left for a 300-kilometer journey from Adilabad to Hyderabad. Sheikh Faizan, the three-year-old boy, had actually met with an accident. An auto had actually rammed into him. That is when he was grievously injured. He was rushed to the Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Medical Sciences, like you said, where he was referred. After giving him initial treatment, the next day he was referred to Hyderabad. They asked the parents to take him all the way 300 kilometers away from Adilabad to Hyderabad in the state of Telangana. What followed was they hired a private ambulance. They were inside the ambulance. 30 kilometers into the journey, they realized that the oxygen supply wasn't enough for the boy. He was having breathing difficulties. Very cleverly, what the driver did was he stopped at the public healthcare center and he fled from the place. He expected he would be beaten up by the locals who had gathered there, following which the parents had to hire another vehicle and take him all the way back 30 kilometers to Adilabad, because it made more sense rather than coming 270 kilometers to Hyderabad. What followed was, by the time they reached Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Medical Sciences in Adilabad, the boy had succumbed to his injury because of the breathing difficulties. the parents later who had undergone a terrible ordeal, because it's very difficult for parents. For no fault of theirs, they were hopeful that their son would survive because they were being taken to a better hospital. On the way, because of sheer lack of oxygen facilities and sheer lack of sheer negligence, I beg your pardon, the boy succumbed to his injuries. They staged a protest along with relatives right outside the hospital. They demanded that the hospital staff be taken to task, the ambulance driver be taken to task. Later, a case was registered against the auto driver as well as the ambulance driver. Now a probe is underway and they're trying to find out what exactly led to the death, and they're trying to book both the auto driver as well as the ambulance driver for this terrible death.
Moving on to news from the state of Maharashtra now, we saw in recent times Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis visit Versova beach and really say that a litter policy is now being formulated by the government and that all beaches will be cleaned. In fact, Mirror Now did a ground check and went to all of the beaches in the city of Mumbai to do a ground check and actually rate them based on how clean they are. Take a look at this report.
Maharashtra Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis and Yuva Sena Chief Aditya Thackeray on Sunday dirtied their hands picking trash as the Versova Beach cleanup campaign resumed after a brief gap. The CM and Junior Thackeray joined the beach cleaning drive with activist Afroz Shah, who has won accolades in India and abroad for the initiative.
उन्होंने ये निर्णय लिया था कि वो इसको बंद करेंगे. कुछ नॉन कॉपरेशन था, कुछ उनको तकलीफ हो रही थी. हम सबने उनसे निवेदन किया कि हम लोग उनके पीछे खड़े हैं और उन्होंने इसको फिर शुरू करना चाहिए. उन्होंने इस बात को माना, वापस उसको शुरू किया और आज उनको समर्थन देने के लिए हम लोग यहाँ पर आए हैं.
But what about the other beaches in Mumbai? Those that do not have an Afroz Shah to clean up, those that are not in the media glare. Mirror Now did a ground check and happily enough, we did find some beaches that were extremely clean, but there were quite a few that disappointed. Here is our list of the best and worst beaches in Mumbai. Mumbai's most visited and most crowded beaches were also its most cleanest. Girgaon Chowpatty and Juhu Beach came out tops, possibly because constant efforts are made to clean it up.
अभी तो बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है. अभी हमेशा आने के लिए मन कर रहा है क्योंकि जो जिस तरह से सफाई हुई है बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है.
एकदम बेस्ट में बेस्ट. पहले हम लोग आता था उससे तो 100 गुना बेस्ट है.
हम लोग पहले भी इधर आते थे लेकिन ये बीच बहुत गंदा रहता था. आने का जी नहीं करता था. बच्चे लोग नीचे खेल नहीं सकते थे, अपन बैठ नहीं सकते. वो एकदम बहुत अच्छा है.
We found Dadar Chowpatty, Gandhigram Beach near Juhu and Aksa Beach amongst the dirtiest in the city.
अलग अलग जगह से यहाँ पे बीच पे प्रैक्टिस करने के लिए आते हैं, फ्लिप्स की, स्टंट्स की, क्योंकि प्लेस नहीं है ना, तो हम लोग चाहते हैं कि हम यहाँ पर कभी कभी बहुत ज़्यादा गंदा होता है, तो हम चाहते हैं कि वो थोड़ा सा साफ रहे.
बाहर से कोई घूमने आता तो अभी वो लोग भी नहीं आना यहाँ पसंद करते क्योंकि यहाँ पे इतना कचरा हो गया है. अभी ये बीच इतना अच्छा था कि हम लोग प्रैक्टिस करते थे तो पहले बहुत लोग से बाहर बाहर से लोग देखने आते थे, अभी वो लोग बिल्कुल नहीं आते.
Mumbai still dumps untreated sewage into the sea and these beaches are literally at the receiving end. So bad are the condition that people no longer frequent these beaches.
Although the basic responsibility of cleaning up the garbage on beaches in Mumbai lies with the BMC, but the Versova model certainly seeks community participation to make the beaches in Mumbai at par with the international standards. And this will certainly be an example and set an example for the other beaches in Mumbai to be cleaned up as well. This is Richa Sharma for Mirror Now here in Mumbai. Now on to our continued focus from the state of Gujarat. We've been getting you stories ahead of the election season. Of course, this time around, the Self-Employed Association, which is working along with the Gujarat government, is entirely trying to empower women and create an identity for their own, to also start their own businesses and make profits for themselves. In fact, Mirror Now visited Seva headquarters. Take a look.
The Seva Cooperative Federation is a federation, as its name suggests, of 106 primary women's cooperatives here in Gujarat. Of course, we have cooperatives in other states where Seva is active, So total within the Seva movement, there are 115 women-owned cooperatives. These are economic organizations, membership-based organizations, used, run and managed and owned by the poor women workers themselves. So as we organize the workers into their own informal workers union, women themselves organically brought out the several issues. One issue was that if we raise minimum wages, the issue of minimum wages with contractors, middlemen and employers, then we don't get work. It affects our livelihood directly. So the whole idea of cooperatives, these economic collective business of women, came from the women as an alternative or an addition, as a supplement and complement to the union. We have, of course, the wonderful example of Amul before us, which is not only in Gujarat but now spread all over the country, and Dr. Kurian's vision, and similarly Ila Ben's vision. When she went to Israel in the 70s, she saw how 75% of the country was run through cooperatives. It was such a big part of the Israeli economy at that time. And this, the idea of cooperatives is part of the idea of Swaraj, Gram Swaraj, that Gandhiji spoke of. Decentralized economic organizations used, managed and owned by the poor themselves. And we believe that it is this that will help people out of poverty. Of course, over the years, we've had good support from the Gujarat government, particularly the cooperative department. In the initial years, I must say, they found some of our ideas for forming cooperatives rather unusual, like a childcare cooperative or healthcare cooperative or cleaners cooperative. They kept saying, but what will you manufacture? So we said, we'll be manufacturing our services as well. Took a little while for them to get it. 2 years we struggled along. But now we've had good support both from the Gujarat government and also from the central government's Department of Cooperatives.